You're talking about when the cops come in, you do not guard your language.
No.
Okay.
No.
Go ahead. Tell us about that.
Well, when the cops come in, what this is about is last year when I was filming some of the stuff that happened at the 101, I had somebody actually complain about the language that we were using because we use some pretty colorful adjectives when we're dealing with the cops, and it's a heated situation, a lot of emotion. So we just go off. We yell, we scream, we make a spectacle, we try to get as much attention, as many eyes on the situation as possible, because even at 3 o'clock in the morning over at the 101, there are people from the Hyatt out, there are cameras across the street that are not occupied cameras, and these get the story out to a whole different group of people, and we effectively did that a lot last year.
Would you call that a protest strategy?
Yeah, these
getting attention?
Yeah, it was all discussed. We had plans last year. For everything that they came up with, we had to counter every action that the police took. And we were successful until the drugs and the alcohol, which is our biggest problem, and it's going to be our problem again in this.
What do you mean, Mike?
Well, the easiest way to take down what we're going to try here by occupying this plaza is to send people to us that have drug, alcohol, or our 5150, which is, crazy people, the wing nuts. The police send them to us. And they create a spectacle that the passers-by blame on Occupy. It gives us a black eye. It discredits us. They've been using it successfully in the media. One or two bad apples in a situation, and it spoils everything for everybody who wanted to become part of Occupy.
What do you mean the police send you the 5150s? What does
5150s,
that mean?
Okay. Last year, we had a white van pull up, and it released three people still in hospital gown with the bracelets from the 72-hour lockup that they do when they pick up somebody who's not acting right, a crazy person.
How do you know?
Because they came in with the bracelets.
That identify them.
Yeah, all the information was on it. And we had people witness them actually dropping the people off around the corner telling them to come to us. We've also had police cars literally pull up, push drunk people out of the back into the middle of the protest because it's easier for us to take care of them than for the police. And
now, is that the reason they do that? That they dump them on you?
It makes us look bad.
Okay.
And they know, a lot of the cops know that the occupiers who are at the 101, we will take care of the problem. If there is somebody who's drunk that needs to be guarded, that needs to be protected, we're going to protect them. We were up all night, every night down there to make sure that our stuff didn't get stolen or that, any number of bad things. Because we did have four stabbings, not us necessarily, a couple of them were us. But we helped in two other stabbings that occurred down here. We actually conducted several citizens' arrests on assault suspects.
I think Nick nearly pantless.
Nick
was
got one. I got two. Because Nick had left. If Nick had been there at the time, he probably would have gotten all three of them. Rob Benson helped out with one on the woman Lilith got her arm broken by a guy. Now, that particular situation, there was a whole group of them. And we got the guy who broke Lilith's arm actually said, the police said, go to Occupy, mess them up, we're not going to do anything.
Lilith, a woman?
Yeah, Lilith is a woman.
Wow.
We have video that night of the police coming in over a three-hour period. This whole fight was taking place at the 101. Three different times the cops showed up, three different times they drove away. When there were fist fights in the street because their provocateur was in here just totally messing up everything. And he was drunk, he was not leaving, he would not listen to reason. The only thing he wanted was violence. And then when we actually got the police there, we pointed him out because he was right around the corner. The police were like, oh, okay. And they didn't do anything. The next day, we had to conduct a citizen's arrest on the guy. He came right back to the protest site to continue messing with us. We conducted an arrest. The Fed cops came out. They did not help restrain the gentleman. They did not do anything other than call it in. They were not allowed to touch this guy, even though the cops. And SFPD responded in about 5 minutes. Sergeant Frazier, was very delighted. We had our paperwork in order. Everything was perfect on this arrest. And nobody will ever know about it. But we held our own out there. That's what we wanted to do. We are a legitimate group of protesters. I don't drink. I don't do drugs. I don't have a criminal history. I was employed until my health failed. That story is played out repeatedly out here. And the sad thing is some of the best people that we've had last year have fallen. They are now using drugs because of pressure of the streets, and we want to set this up for another reason, just besides occupying for the boat race and everything that the boat race represents. We want our people to come back, to be with their family, and we want to try to lift them back up out of the position that they're in.
They're occupied family.
They're occupied family. They're well-known occupiers. I'm not going to go into names or details, but it is serious. It is very serious. These people are dying out here for these issues that Occupy is going to be facing if the police allow us. And I know we can save at least two of them.
How?
Least two of them. we're going to support them. We're going to intervene. We're going to say, look, this is not how you want to live. And we're going to try to just prevent it. And I'm an alcoholic. I quit drinking 13 years ago. As that in my background, I can sit here and say, they're not going to change until they're ready to change.
Right.
And all we can do is try and let them know, okay, we understand. And not pressure them to change, but if they're not going to change, if they're going to continue doing drugs, they have to understand they can't be here. This is a protest, not a party. We cannot take the black eye again. We've got to build this movement. I don't know of any other movement out there. I had one person mentioning Idle No More. I was really hoping to see a lot of Idle No More stuff out here. And the pipeline thing is huge. The fracking is huge. Mm-hmm. It's just horrible what's going on. Mm-hmm. And we had, I think at our high, probably 100, 120 people today. It wasn't a great turnout, but it's a start. You know, this whole thing started because three people started drawing on the sidewalk with chalk. And that's
and to get this many people, it's very good.
It took a few months to just, it's going to come together. The people will come. We just need to do stuff. Get the word out. I'm going to open up. I set up an Occupy San Francisco Facebook group or something, a page, a few months back, just in case we lost the OSF page because I posted the war photo. We were really concerned that they were going to like yank the page because it was a Syrian family that got hit. And I mean, it showed everything, the blown up family. Four dead kids and a dead mother. We were the first major Occupy page to do that too. So, and Occupy Wall Street followed suit and posted up a couple. They actually changed their format to duplicate what we were doing. But then I got removed from the page because things really, I started posting the truth and people just weren't ready to hear. And maybe I should have slowed down a little bit. The Sandy Hook fiasco, people don't think that we're right when we say it's fake. It's a false flag designed to get gun control. And there's enough evidence online that shows that something strange did happen, whether or not kids got killed, I really don't know. I hope to God they didn't, but I fear that, yeah, our government will kill kids to further their agenda in our own country. They've already killed an American citizen with a drone. Mm-hmm. You know, that happened overseas.
That's right. How many American soldiers in Iraq for nothing? How many Iraqis did they kill for nothing?
Couple million.
I mean, I don't think that they care much about who they kill.
No, if it makes money, you know.
Right.
It's all in a buck.
Right.